In this video, we're going over the top 5 problems on this first generation Chevy HHR. Number 1, the VVT solenoid valves. Now they're located right here. You have an intake one and an exhaust one. And this is what's gonna control the variable valve timing of the camshafts. Some of the symptoms you're gonna have when these valves go bad is a rough running engine, a check engine light that has codes related to those valves, and sometimes the vehicle will actually stall. One thing that's crucial about these valves is oil changes and the oil level. If the oil level gets down, these valves aren't gonna be working properly and that's gonna cause them to fail. Number 2, the throttle body. Now, the throttle body is located right here. And some of the conditions you're gonna notice is the engine running a little rough. Sometimes the idle will be extremely low and maybe even a stalling condition, but also a check engine light with a throttle body related code. In most cases, you cannot just clean the throttle body, you have to replace it. Number 3, the coolant system. Normally on GM vehicles, you wanna flush the coolant every 150,000 miles or every 5 years. On this system, you probably wanna flush it every 60,000 miles. Sometimes the coolant can plug up the heater core or even plug up the radiator. Most of the time it's the heater core. You can try to flush out the heater core, but it doesn't always work and you have to replace it. To be proactive, change your coolant more often than not. Number 4, the gas cap. Most of the time you'll get an EVAP code with a check engine light and you might have a gas cap problem. You wanna check and make sure nothing's loose and also check the seal. And a lot of times these caps end up with a bad ratchet. So double check the ratchet on the cap. Make sure it's nice and tight and replace it if you need to. Number 5, no power steering. Now this vehicle has electronically assisted power steering and you may notice after you jump start the vehicle or somebody jump starts the vehicle that the steering's not working properly. If you take the fuse box cover off, it actually explains how you're supposed to jump start the vehicle. But if you did not follow the directions correctly, you may have popped this 60 amp fuse. This fuse is the electronic power steering fuse. So in that case, just put a new fuse in there and double check your power steering. It should be working fine. So there's our top 5 problems for this Chevy HHR. Overall, these are great vehicles. If you enjoyed this video or it helped you out, make sure you subscribe to our channel, ring the bell, turn on all notifications so you don't miss any of our videos.